And welcome back to the Financially Simple Podcast. Today we're going to continue our deep dive into cash flow for us business owners. Remember, we're talking personal finances, and I'm answering today's question, should I pay my children from the business? So when I looked this up on Google, I found out there's over 350 million search results for this one question. The very first article I came across, it said, new tax law makes hiring your kids a better idea than ever. I don't know about you, but that sounds pretty intriguing to me. And truth be told, what we're covering today is a strategy that many of the tax planners we work with as financial, CR-certified financial planners, and as advisors to business owners, we utilize this strategy many, many, many times. So the idea being is you may want to hire your kids or your children to work in your business. But why? Why? You may want to, number one, teach them to be an entrepreneur. That's not a bad idea. If my parents were business owners when I was a kid, I could just see them hiring me to work in the business for this particular reason. In fact, they weren't even entrepreneurs, and they tried to teach me entrepreneurship, and they did successfully. Me and my brother both are business owners, and my sister's husband is now a business owner or a part business owner. So we all had this entrepreneur bug, and that was from parents who decided to try to teach us the entrepreneurial role. The other thing that, you know, us business owners may want to do by hiring our kids is to teach them a strong work ethic. I mean, just teach kids how to work. I have an opinion, my personal opinion, feel free to make it yours, that as long as we teach our kids how to work and be ethical, they'll do anything they can in life. Those two things, to love to work hard. As my dad one time said, he said, son, you're a Goodbread. There better not ever be another man on the job site who outworks you. I'll never forget that as long as I live. And I've taken that as my ethos, as my motto in my life, is to work harder than any other person, especially another man on the job site. I want to be known as a hardworking individual. I also want to be known as one that's ethical. That's a value that my mom and dad taught me. And they taught me that by teaching me entrepreneurship. We can do the same things, us business owners, to teach our kids a strategy. The cool thing about it is if we hire our kids, they can get paid tax-free. Up to $12,000 a year, tax-free. And cool about this is many times you can create a tax deduction on the business and run them through the payroll cycle, and they pay no taxes on their side. So tax deduction, tax-free, pretty sweet. So adding your kids to the payroll can be a great strategy. Now, there's lots of rules here, lots of rules. So I'm going to tell you today, I'm hitting the high level on this. I'm going to try to dive down and get you some interesting insight into this particular topic. But this does not in no means replace your good tax planner. I'm not your tax planner. In fact, I'm not a tax planner. I'm a certified financial planner, certified exit planning advisor, and certified value growth advisor. My job is to make people's net worth grow. So I come up with ideas. Sometimes they're really good. Sometimes they're really bad. Sometimes the CPAs and tax attorneys will say, Justin, you are smoking crack. You cannot do that. That is wrong. Okay, back off. Sometimes they say, man, I never thought about that. Let's do research and then lo and behold, it's a good idea. This is not one of those topics. This is pretty much plain vanilla, pretty easy stuff. In fact, I'm going to read you straight from the Internal Revenue Code what they say about this strategy. Yeah, don't go to sleep over there. Please do not turn the podcast off or shut the video off. By the way, we're now recording this for YouTube, and we had so many people say, Justin, we'd like to just watch you as you present things. So my team is going to start adding filters into the videos as they come about so we can point to things, and I can share my screen as well. So in the time being, today I'm going to read you a little bit of from the Internal Revenue Code, and here's what the Internal Revenue Code says about the strategy. It says, children employed by parents. That's the heading. Here we go. Payments for services of children under the age of 18 who work for his or her parent in a trade or business are not subject to Social Security and Medicare taxes if the trade or business is a sole proprietorship or a partnership in which each partner is a parent of the child. Let's stop right there. That's a lot of information. What's it saying? Number one, if our kids are under the age of 18, sweet, this applies to them. If they're under the age of 18 and we own a sole proprietorship, in other words, we file this on a Schedule C, or if we have a partnership, an LLC taxes a partnership or a general partnership in which each partner, so two partners, are a parent, then in that particular situation, the payroll is not subject to Social Security or Medicare taxes. payroll taxes, for example. So let's assume that we pay our child $10,000 a year and self-employment tax is 15.3%. Children don't pay any of that. Let's assume that 7.5% that we are 7.15 or whatever it is percent that us business owners pay on the payroll side of clients for our, for our employees. We don't pay that for our child who is under the age of 18 and who the parent is the owner of a sole proprietor or a partner. Both parents are a partner in a sole proprietor. And that is if that's not the case, we're going to get to that. But we're going to continue here. So it says payments for services of a child under age 21 who works for his or her parent in a trade or business are not subject to Federal Unemployment Tax Act. So FUTA, F-U-T-A is what we say, FICA FUTA. It's not subject to FUTA tax either. Payments of the service of a child are subject to income tax withholding regardless of age. Here's where it gets sweet. The new standard, deduction or the exemption amount for an individual is $12,000. So as long as we pay them $12,000, there's no taxes due. You say, well, Justin, look, I'm not a partnership. I'm an S corporation. Okay. Wages for services of a child are subject to income tax withholding as well as Social Security, Medicare, and FUTA taxes if the child works for a corporation. So if you're an S corp, C corp, sorry, you got to withhold taxes. Or a partnership even if the child's parent is the partner, unless each partner is a parent of the child. So you say, okay, Justin, I have an S corporation, I have a C corporation, I have an LLC, tax is one of those, or I have a partnership and my business partner is not my spouse. In that scenario, the Internal Revenue Service says that your payment to your child is subject to withholding taxes or payroll taxes at that point, okay? All right, that's a lot of information there. But bottom line, what the Internal Revenue Service is saying is, look, you can hire your kids. So I asked myself one time the question, well, is there a minimum age? Used to, I would say, well, you got to make sure the job fits the child. But look, there's no minimum age to this. Well, come on, Justin, I can't hire my three-month-old. Actually, you could. You've lost your mind, Justin. No, not really. If you look on commercials, like the old Gerber baby commercials, I haven't seen one of these in a while. I'm not targeted on social media because our kids are all in diapers. But they're the cute little pudgy babies. I was talking about one of our little babies. He was so pudgy. There's cute little pudgy babies on there. They're sitting in the bathtub. They're sitting in the kitchen sink like our Jude used to do. They're getting paid, friends. So there's no minimum age. The kids you see on TV and those in the bathtub, little pudgy ones there that everybody likes to say, ooh, like I still like, man, I remember that age. It was kind of fun. I'm glad they're out of diapers now, but that was kind of fun. You can actually pay them. Here's the key. You got to keep it all legitimate. You're not trying to create a sham here, a sham job for your kids just to shield income taxes. You don't want to do that. You don't want to say, look, you have some sort of a job, but it's not really quantified. Look, if you get audited, the IRS, they know this stuff. And a good tax advisor, your good CPA that I'm telling you to talk to, they're going to not let you get away with this. It's just not. So you got to have a job that aligns with the child. You have to. The cool thing about it is that it's a way that you can shelter some taxes. It's a way you can shelter some taxes. Well, how big of a deal is it, Justin? It's pretty big. It's pretty big. I was sitting with a CPA and a tax attorney and a business owner this morning, in fact, and we were talking about various strategies. And this is one the CPA brought up. And when I had mentioned it to beforehand, the CPA did some research and they came back and said, man, Justin, we're going to utilize this. And here was what the CPA recommended. They came in, they said, look, Mr. Client, we've been talking behind the scenes. What we think is you need to hire all four of your children. Get this. And we want you to pay them $1,000 a month. And here's the jobs that we see they can work around your particular facility. Okay. Here's the jobs we see that you can work around your facility. And now they got to create the job titles and all that stuff. But if we pay them $1,000 a month for all four of your children, that's $48,000 a year that is tax-free going to that family's house. Let me say that again. That's $48,000 a year tax-free going into the family's house. Think about that. That's a tax deduction on this particular company. It's an LLC, tax as a partnership. Create a tax deduction. We put them in as the payroll in a W-2. So we have them on payroll. All that stuff is what the CPA is recommending. I agree with the CPA in this. But $48,000 a year tax-free. So they're going to go into each individual kid's accounts, and then mom and dad are going to use the kid's money to, guess what? Raise the kids. Do what they've been paying for this whole time. They're going to use it to pay for the education, the college. They're going to use it to pay for the summer camp, the books, the meals at Chick-fil-A. The kids are now going to start carrying their own weight. They're going to buy their own clothes, their own shoes, their own everything. $48,000 a year tax-free. So I've heard CPAs say, a conservative, I'm putting that parenthesis, a conservative CPA say, man, it's just too good. It's not what the IRS says. The IRS allows us to use the tax code to our advantage to lower our taxes. And this is where your good tax advisors can help you. Of course, here's where it gets kind of sticky. Of course, you have to utilize the strategy properly. You have to. So you must put a reasonable job with the age of your child. So, for example, if your child's 16, you may have your 16-year-old running errands for you. They may be your delivery person. We have one client that the 16-year-old who just got their driver's license is delivering parts, okay, just on a part-time job. They come in on one day a week and they deliver parts. You're not going to put your 5-year-old behind the wheel of a car. We know better than that. But your 5-year-old could come in and clean windows for you. They could come in and water the plants. I have a client who pays literally about $1,000 a month just to water the green plants in the office because they have the greenery and they have to keep them alive and no one's going to do it. So they have a plant company who leases out plants and stuff. So the client now pays the child. They fired the plant company and now the child goes and waters the plants and picks off the dead leaves. There's nothing wrong with that. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to make sure the job matches the age. The second thing you're going to do is you're going to keep accurate records. So if your employee base, if they're paid by the hour, you're going to track your child's by the hour. If you're paid by a salary or per the job scenario, like a salary basis, you're going to track the same process. You're not going to make special privileges for your child. You're just not going to do it. You're going to document. You're going to give them a job title. You give them a job title and document the work they have to do. So you have to have a job description. You're going to have an employment agreement should help in this area. You want to have these things where the IRS says, okay, I see you're paying little Timmy here $1,000 a month. What is Timmy doing for you? At that point, you don't want to say, but I don't know. No, your good tax planners are going to say, no, here's his job. So you want to list that out for you. You want to pay your child a reasonable salary, a reasonable amount for the job they do. If the child is there... in our office, we actually pay my two boys to clean the office. Now, that entails a lot here. We have a whole second floor with our current office, and they come in and they mop and they vacuum and they clean the windows and they take out the trash and they shred documents. They literally can spend once a week, we shred documents. Now, we could hire a shredding company. The problem is I don't want to take my client's information, drop it into some box that gets put on a truck somewhere with all this financial information. It's just a procedure we have. So we actually run shredders ourselves. And for a while there, I'd spend 4, 5, 6 hours on the weekend, on the week, just shredding information. That's not a really efficient use of my time. So we hired our kids. And now they love it. They like to see if we have them two shredders, they run them simultaneously. So they spend literally a whole day cleaning and doing the office almost every week. Well, Justin, how much do you pay him? I pay him a reasonable rate. I pay him the same amount of money that we were going to pay, that we were paying the cleaning crew to come in and do that. And I can show that their work, what they're doing is market value. It's okay. So you want to pay them to industry standards. You don't want to pay them a crazy amount of salaries for just for a remedial job. You can't do that. Most tax preparers and tax advisors are not going to let you do that. Because when you come in, the IRS are going to audit you and they're going to say, no, you can't do that. So if your business is set up as a corporation, now you may be required to pay payroll taxes. We talked about that. And you may be required to pay FUTA taxes. You may. So I'm going to talk about that. So let's deal with the corporation problem. You say, well, Justin, I'm an S-Corp. Forget it. I'm not going to pay FICA FUTA. Hold on a second there, Skippy. There's always a way around this. There may be a way that you can pay. So let's go back to what we said earlier. I'm going to read the Internal Revenue Code again. The wages for services of a child are subject to income tax withholding as well as Social Security, Medicare, FICA tax if he or she works for, you ready? A corporation. So a corporation is going to be an S-Corp, a C-Corp, an LLC taxed as such, or a partnership where one of the partners are not a parent. Okay. If you run into that problem, there's often a workaround. There's often a way you can do it. The workaround is this. You can run with what's called many CPAs. In fact, I heard a CPA who first told me this strategy. I heard it on a podcast. I was like, there's no way. So I talked to my tax attorney and yeah, he's right. Yeah, you can do this. So they call it a hybrid approach. What you can do is instead of paying the child from your corporation or your partnership where you don't have both parents as a partner, is you can pay them out of your family management company, a family management company. So Mark Kohler, M-A-R-K Kohler, he runs a podcast called Refresh Your Wealth. I love listening to these guys. They're really smart. He and his partner, Matt Sorensen, they're attorneys, they're tax attorneys. And he was the first one that I heard talk about this family management company. And I'll put a link in the show notes to his particular podcast. It's called Refresh Your Wealth. It's a fun one to listen to. He's got some really cool creative ideas. But basically what you're going to do is you're going to set up a management company or a sole proprietor separate from your corporation, separate from your S-Corp, your C-Corp, or your LLC tax as such. And the only purpose of this new management company is to support the operations of your company or your corporation. Okay, so they're going to include scheduling and monitoring the jobs to be done by your children. All right, so get this. You now set up a family management company. That's now a sole proprietorship, Schedule and Schedule C, and this company is designed to employ your kids with your corporation. So your corporation is going to pay your Schedule C management company. Your Schedule C management company is then going to pay your children. It's a workaround, okay? Again, you have to follow the same rules in the management company as you do with a partnership or a sole proprietorship. You still have to follow the same rules. It's just a workaround. It's just an idea that you can use. Again, talk to your planner. There's lots of ideas out there like this, and your CPA, your tax preparer, may not agree with the famous Mark Kohler. Here's the bottom line. When you put your child on the payroll, you're going to be able to take money that you potentially are paying at a higher tax bracket and divert it to a lower tax bracket or to a no tax bracket. The other thing you're going to do is you're going to reduce the businesses because the business is getting a deduction for the wages paid. So you're going to be able to lower your business deduction, your business taxes. So some states out there have different taxing effects. By paying the kids, you're shifting dollars from a high tax bracket to a low tax bracket. The key then is your kids can now pay for their own expenses. They can pay for their own expenses. They can pay their own way on a family vacation, friends. There's so much they can do with this idea. So I've seen this strategy that have been deployed by many of our tax partners around the country. It saved thousands of dollars in taxes. But more importantly, it helps create family business. See, it's really sad to me that so many family businesses don't survive to the second generation. I'm of the opinion, I can't prove this mathematically, maybe you know a study that you can look at. I'm of the opinion that the sooner we can get our kids involved in business, and especially the family business, the more, treat them right. I'm not saying abuse them. You're not trying to run a kid's sweat factory here by no means. But as soon as you get them in there, the more likely that they're going to want to one day help run the business. I was sitting in a lecture one time from a famous author, and he wrote a book called Every Family Business. And in this book, he talks about how the wealthy train the next generation. And what they do is exactly what I'm talking about. They get them involved in the business, and in addition to paying them to work in the business, they also pay them to learn the business. They have them sitting around the business planning meetings, just sitting there taking notes. They're trying to teach the kids life. There's no better way to do that and at the same time generate some tax deductions. So we're going to put a list of 50 plus ideas on how some jobs for kids that I've been brainstorming and pulling different things through. So I'll give you a couple here. You can have them purchase supplies. my Savannah, we give her the supply list. So what a part of her job is to go out and purchase supplies for us and make sure they come and then stock them in the right places. You can have them, as I talk, my boys clean the windows, they water the plants, they clean the office, they shred documents. I have some clients whose their children clean their vehicles. They go in and actually wash and wax the vehicles as a family on the weekends. I mean, to pay a detailer is ridiculous in some places. So you can pay your kids to do that. You can have them sit in corporate meetings. I talked about that. One of the things my Savannah does is she sits in corporate meetings and takes meeting notes for us. You can have them valet park at events. I had one client that did this. He had his 17-year-old son actually valet park the client cars when they showed up to the event. It's a pretty amazing idea. You can have them run errands. You can send out birthday cards. There's so many different ideas that you can hire your child for in your business. You can have them as photograph, put them on the websites as stand-in pictures. Now, again, everything has to be legit. I'm not saying not to do this. I'm not saying that to try to scheme the system. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying here's a strategy on why you may want to pay your kids out of the business. And with that, we're going to wrap up this episode. You know, I say it every week, life is hard. It is. Life is good and life can be frustrating. Look, making money doesn't have to be. Money doesn't have to be frustrating. We're going to continue to make our lives at least financially simple. Hey, y'all go out and make it a great day.